so great to all be together today. For those of you who may not have been here on our first weekend, myself included, we would like to provide a few reminders for the success of today's gathering. A face covering or mask must be worn at all times from the time you exit your car until you re-enter your car. This is not an option. Face coverings or masks must cover your nose and mouth. The only exception will be at the time of communion. Regarding communion, we will follow the same flow to and from communion as was previously done, with the exception that there will only be one line leading to the priest or Eucharistic minister, and you must keep 6 feet distance, and we have blue markings on the rug for guidance. Please wait for the usher to indicate when it is time for your section to proceed to communion. We encourage the use of hand sanitizer before and after receiving communion. When approaching Father Jack or the Eucharistic minister, be sure your mask is on and hold hands flat out to receive the host. Move off to the designated spot to remove your mask and consume the host. Reposition your mask and then return to your seat. Please try to remain seated during Mass. There is an usher assigned to each section that will assist you with anything that you may need. Please follow the directions of your usher for communion and exiting. In the case of an emergency where you would need to exit quickly, please find the nearest exit to your section and exit in an orderly manner. Again, ushers are here to assist you. Both restrooms are open. Responses that are normally sung will be recited. At the end of Mass, Father Jack will exit the sanctuary first. The ushers will then indicate to their sections when to exit, beginning with the center two sections being empty, followed by the two side sections. Bulletins will be provided on the tables upon exiting. Please remain on your side of the building all the way out through the side front doors into the parking lot, and please refrain from congregating in the parking lot, adhering to 6 foot social distancing. Welcome to St. Joseph's Church. We're all happy to be back together again. This is the time when we normally greet our neighbor, but just gaze upon your neighbor and just be thankful to be able to be in this beautiful church together again. It is a pleasure, in the middle of these languorous summer months, to sit back and listen to stories. The crowds in the gospel were able to do just that, for Jesus taught them by telling parables. Parables made his lessons about the kingdom of heaven memorable in ways in which straightforward narration would fail. Now it is our turn to listen. Let us savor them, ruminating on their rich images and considering their meaning in our lives. Today's Mass is offered for the parishioners of St. Joseph's Church, and please let us stand as our liturgy is about to begin.
Thank you.
no God besides you who have the care of all, that you need show you have not unjustly condemned. For your might is the source of justice. Your mastery over all things makes you lenient to all. For you show your light when the perfection of your power is disbelieved, and in those who know you, you rebuke temerity. But though you are master of might, you judge with clemency, and with much leniency you govern us, for power, whenever you will, attends you. And you taught your people by these deeds that those who are just must be kind. And you gave your children good ground for hope that you would permit repentance for their sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial hymn, Lord, you are good and forgiving.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
You, O Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in kindness to all who call upon you. Hearken, O Lord, to my prayer, and attend to the sound of my pleading.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
All the nations you have made shall come and worship you, O Lord, and glorify your name, for you are great and you do wondrous deeds.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
You, O Lord, are a good God, merciful and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in kindness and fidelity. Turn toward me and have pity on me. Give me your strength, your servant.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings, and the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones, according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Would uproot the wheat along with that. put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that someone took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, but when it has grown, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nests in the branches. He told them, among another parable, the kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until it was all leavened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Talk about the weeds. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
It is very interesting to hear and to receive the comment that was made in our opening reflections for today's liturgy. We all love to tell stories. We all love to listen to stories. No matter how we may embellish them, no matter how we may choose to receive. And isn't that one of the beauties and the dignities that we see in Jesus? He tells stories. He speaks in parables. But like all of our stories, there is an underlying reality that we take and share self or the other or others. And that's exactly what we experience Jesus doing today, as he speaks to us in these beautiful stories that he shares with us in our liturgy. And I think that if we're to take that reality and to look at the other stories, other realities that are shared with us in today's scriptures, we come to know and appreciate a tremendous reality, a tremendous fact about God in ourselves. The prophet says to us this morning, and reminds us as he tells his story, about a God who very much cares about his people. We hear that prophet saying to us that care that God has for and with us is based in justice, kindness, isn't that exactly what we hear Jesus saying in parable storytelling today? When he speaks about the care for and the care of even the simple things of the earth, whether they be the weeds or the wheat, whether they be the mustard seed or the sparrow. Isn't that also what we hear Paul saying to us about that spirit that has been given to us? And I think we could wrap all of this together very beautifully as we hear in prayer our responsorial psalm. The Lord is kind. I think that gathered together in this holy place, in this mountain, in this seashore, as we see Jesus doing it so vividly with his followers. I think that if we are to look at these three images that Jesus gives to us today, we come to know something wonderful about our God, ourselves, and each other. Jesus reminds all of us that he has sown seeds, or that God has sown seeds. That among these seeds, there will be wheat. There will be weeds. God gives all of it a chance to grow, mature, develop, to make choices. What about the weeds and the wheat that is in each of us, in all of us? Gratefully, God, who is kind and merciful, has allowed those to grow and to develop as we make choices. And as we make choices in the eyes of the caring and loving God. I think the other image that we see is that of the mustard seed, the smallest of, which becomes the largest of. And I think that is a great point to see what it is that Paul is saying to us today about that spirit that God has imbued within each of us. That is the story that is unique and special to each and every one of us. It is extremely important for the reality of all of us as the kingdom of God. Jesus says in the gospel reading today, let them grow. When they come to fruition, we will make a choice. Paul reminds us that a God who is cares for and with us has given us that same ability to be his messenger of kindness and forgiveness. And Paul reminds us that this gift, that this seed, this spirit has been given to us to share with all people, those who are in need, those who are hurt, those who are responding to, even those who are rejecting us. So yes, we do enjoy to listen to stories. We do enjoy adding our own little pieces to that puzzle of life. But are we ready to listen to hear the story of God that is part and parcel of each of us, and that we will to go forth and to be the messenger, the living spirit of God who is kind and merciful. Of God who is kind and free.
My sisters and brothers, let us implore the Holy Spirit to intercede on behalf of those who are in need.
Our response today is, Lord, hear our prayer. That we, the Church, will continue to establish and strengthen the kingdom of God in a world suffering from poverty and injustice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
those who lead us in government will work to create profound respect for the dignity of human life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That married couples in our community will be strengthened in their covenant and be a sign of Christ among us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffer from addictions and of any kind will receive the strength they need to seek help and freedom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That scientists, health professionals, public officials, and all who are serving the common good in this difficult and uncertain time will be filled with wisdom and understanding, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick will know healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the benefactors of this holy church, for those who have gone before us in faith, and for the people of the parishes of Our Lady of Grace and St. Joseph's, that they experience the peace of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. We turn to you, O God of kindness and mercy, and ask that you hear the prayer of your people. As we prepare to celebrate the Eucharist, open our hearts for the action of your Holy Spirit. And we ask this. All this wonder. To rule in your name over all that you have made, become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this Eucharist. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, take this, all of you, and eat. This is my body, which was given up for you. When supper was ended, he took the cup again and gave you thanks and praise, gave that cup to his disciples, and said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It'll be shed for you and for all people, so that sin might be forgiven. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord Jesus, until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of eternal salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partake of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and with our Bishop, Howard, Bishop Emeritus, with all bishops, clergy, religious, and the entire people set at stake for his health. Remember also all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep with the hope of the resurrection, of all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face, have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit and co-heirs into your life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God is our Father, and Jesus our brother, and therefore we have the right and the privilege to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and all unnecessary anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory of
Lord Jesus Christ, you said your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and grant us peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other silent God's love.
Peace be with you, babe.
Peace
be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins.
filled with heavenly mysteries, to pass from